December, or as I'm calling it, Krampus Month. Mm-hmm. And I am with the awesome Amy Mercury, and we are definitely feeling in the spirits. Mm-hmm. Today, we are going to talk about this really awesome book, which unfortunately I only have for my Kindle app. It is called A Kiss from Krampus by Red Hanner, an erotic Christmas tale. Tale spelled T-A-I-L.
Appropriately.
Yes. And,
it's yeah, a fun book.
It's exactly what it sounds like. It's a sexy book about Krampus. And if you don't know who Krampus is...
Well, let's see. Krampus... Okay, like, you know, we recommend you do a little bit of research, but Krampus is sort of, kind of like the anti-Santa Claus, if you will. Yes. Instead of, like, rewarding children, he punishes bad children. Yes. And, like, in, you know, certain, like, Northern European countries, they actually have, like, a holiday celebration just for Krampus.
Yes, it's on December 6th, I believe, usually. Mm-hmm. Called Krampus Night.
And, like, his whole thing is, like, you know, while, like, Santa is, like, the good guy, like, okay, you're a good kid, here's your, you know, presents and stuff, Krampus, on the other hand, punishes children by spanking them with reeds or sticks.
Yeah.
Sometimes kidnapping them.
Puts them in a bag and he spanks them. Mm-hmm. Show us the little thing that you have. This is amazing.
This is fun. This is, I hang it up every year.
Oh, see, there's Krampus, and he's taken away the naughty kid. And look at his wicked tree branch thing.
This is wicked children beware.
Ooh. So scary, Krampus! Oh no!
Yeah, Krampus sweater. I forgot about that. I'm gonna have to bring that out later.
To bring that out. Yes, yeah, gotta wear it for your ugly Christmas sweater party.
Yes.
Okay, so you're probably thinking, well, okay, Krampus. He punishes naughty children, and this is a sexy book. What are you talking about, Quinn and Amy? This is creepy. What? Okay. Don't worry, it's not. I mean, it's creepy if you're not into the whole monster boyfriend thing,
right?
Which, you know, we kind of are. Monster mm-hmm. boyfriend. It's also kind of the similar vein of, like, the Born Sexy Yesterday trope. You know what I'm talking about.
Right, right.
But this is, okay, so this story is about a young woman. She's, like, what, mid-late 20s.
Mm-hmm. And grad student.
Yeah, and she is going and has to go back home to visit one of her grandmothers who is dying.
Mm-hmm. And this is the grandma she doesn't particularly like.
Yeah, she has, like, two grandmothers that, you know, she loved. They basically both raised her. Yeah, there's quite a bit of backstory in this. It gets you really involved. Mm-hmm. They both raised her back and forth. One of them is, like, one that she really loves. The other one is just one that's just evil. Like, she's just mean and has always been nasty, like, her whole life.
But she's loaded.
She's loaded.
And our main character is trying to be on the will, right?
Yes, she wants to get that inheritance. So she goes back home, and the grandmother is dying, and she's about to tell her something that's very important, this little, like, gold trinket thing that she has, and she's like, you have to hold on to this, like, this is how I'm able to do whatever I want, and you'll be able to do whatever you want as long as you always hold on to this and you never, ever open it. So the girl is... like, just thinking, oh, Graham's off her rocker, you know, clearly, mm-hmm. clearly she, you know, she's close to death.
Right.
This is kind of ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
So, mm-hmm. do you want to tell what?
Well, like, so she has this little trinket, and she finds out that there's more to this trinket than meets the eye. I believe she, like, accidentally, like, breaks it open.
Yeah, she opens it after the grandmother dies, because mm-hmm. the grandmother is about to tell her...
What's in it,
why she's always been, like, nasty and can do whatever she wants.
And all of a sudden, you know, that's it. And so, you know, she's like, well, okay, I don't know what this trinket is. She's too busy, like, kind of get ready for, like, funeral plans.
Yeah.
But this trinket gets broken open, and she is then visited by this creature, you know, tall, horned, kind of, pagan-y goat creature.
Yes.
And, he seems very interested in her. Yeah.
He's like, wait a minute, because he thinks that she is the grandmother, but like as a child, and she was like, wait. He's like, wait a minute, you're not. Why aren't you a child? What is happening? And he's like, where is,
it's like, you're a grown up.
Where is this? You know, bad girl. And she's like, well, she died. What are you talking about? And, mm-hmm. and he's like, well, I guess you're gonna have to get the spanking. So he spanks her, and it's like just uncomfortable, and because there's no. It's just, we're getting a little off. a little into the details here.
Well, ultimately, it turns into, like, this, you know, I think they've kind of, like, made this sort of connection between Krampus and sort of, like, pagan gods, because he's very sexual.
Yeah.
He's
very sexual.
And they initiate sexual...
yes.
content.
Sexual things happen. And,
very quickly.
But the thing is, the little trinket had a piece of his beard in it, mm-hmm. that when the grandmother was a little girl, she cut off part of Krampus's beard, and it had this little, like, bead, of course, carved out of reindeer bone, and that is, like, what seals his power, and that has become lost, because the girl broke it. What is her name? The main character's name? Let me look it up. See, now mm-hmm. I can't seem to recall.
But, well, you know, we find, like, it was first
a little bit of a mystery.
Right. It's like, the, you know, this girl, like, you know, she's rather confused by all of this at the beginning.
Like, why am I attracted to this strange goat man?
But he's really good in bed. So.
Of course, why wouldn't he be? But it's also, like, because I mentioned he's kind of like the Born Sexy yesterday. She's wanting to teach him, because he's been, like, the thing is, he's been, like, kind of locked away.
Right.
Because his beard and the magic bead were sealed.
Mm-hmm.
And
so, like, he's missed out on, like, several decades worth of time.
Oh, yeah. And so he hasn't been able to do his job. I can't quite remember her name, but it's not all that important. But she, you know, like, she's about to inherit, she's going to inherit all this money, and so, like, it's very much, like, a self-insert kind of thing, like, oh, this is kind of cool. I don't know, they really, it's not, like, just smut, though. Like, the story is actually pretty compelling.
It is an interesting story.
It gives you the good feelings of Christmas as an adult, I guess. I don't know, but it also...
Right.
Wow, like, we're not explaining this very well at all, are we? It's just, you know, it's perverted. It's a chick and a monster. Like,
I was like, what
okay,
are you those two?
I'm sorry, Shape of Water won Best Picture...
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's a reason why people are into this kind of thing. Mm-hmm.
I think, I want to say, like, the writer herself, Red Hanner, had originally written it as a joke. Like,
yeah.
She was like, this is just something funny, and she did it as an exercise.
Mm-hmm.
And it actually got, you know, a fair amount of attention, and people liked it, because they're like, well, what is that?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, there's a series of Bigfoot erotica called Come for Bigfoot.
What?
Yes. And the girl kind of like, the writer of the stories had just written it as kind of a joke. Just wanted to see, like...
So this, like, let's write something as a joke.
With monsters, and it actually took off. Like, she was, the creator of Come for Bigfoot was making, like, $30,000 a month on this book.
Wow.
You know?
Well...
On just selling it on Amazon, so kind of same thing.
That's really cool. So, yeah, so with the Kiss from Krampus is, yes, it's very sexy. It's also, you know, there's a little bit of taboo stuff in there, some, like, mocking religious practices and kind of things. Like, they end up having sex in a confessional at a church, the Catholic church.
So lots of blasphemy.
Yeah, there's quite a bit of blasphemy going on. But yeah,
all tasteful.
It's very tasteful.
Tasteful blasphemy.
No, it's definitely, if you like weird smut, or if you just kind of want to laugh, because, you know, it's kind of, mm-hmm. I mean, if,
it's rather tongue-in-cheek.
With myself, like, I personally kind of enjoy, like, you know, silly smut.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, read it at your own risk. But it's also, you can have a fun evening. You know, the way some people like to read the 50 Shades books out loud and be funny with each other, like, you mm-hmm. can kind of do that with this book, too.
Exactly.
Kiss from Krampus. Let's see. Red Hanner wrote another book about this chick and Cupid, which I got about halfway through. I didn't really like it that much. I might give it another try. But Kiss from Krampus...
Oh, it was very well written, honestly.
Yeah, it was. It's you can follow it really well, and it's, you know, if you're if you're around the age. Yeah, you're mid to late 20s, you're a lady who likes likes freaky deaky monster men, then this is definitely the book for you.
Because there's, unfortunately, a lot of, like, especially, like, on Amazon, there's a lot of, like, monster porn that's admittedly not very well written.
Yeah, and this is actually really well written, and, like, the characters, like, because it, I mean, yes, it is smutty, but it's also, like, the story's actually, like I said, it's very interesting. Like, you want to know what's going to happen. You want them to be able to stay together, even though it doesn't really make any sense at all.
But you're rooting for them the whole time. You're like, yeah, we really want these kids together.
Yeah, and it's bizarre. And it's a good payoff. Like, I don't want to spoil it, because, like, I do want this book to get more attention. Because it had to have gotten quite a bit of attention. I think it came out in, like, 2014, maybe?
Maybe even earlier.
Maybe earlier.
Yeah. It's been out a while. You know, it's kind of like a holiday tradition for me.
Oh, yeah, you're the one that told me about it last year. Yeah, because I was really getting into Krampus, and you were like, there's a book. And I was like, what?
And it's very, you know, it's so fun, and I read it every year.
Oh, it came out in
2012,
yeah. Also, it hasn't been too long.
So it's...
I think my only complaint from the book, besides that there's not more,
right,
is because, yes, it is a smutty book, and they do have this woman does have a sexual relationship with Krampus. Like, I'm sorry, but he does spank her with the but it's like a punishment, like, you know, it's she doesn't like it or anything.
Right.
I kind of just from my, like, you know, it's a monster guy, you feel, and he's got that, like, tongue, and, you know, you should. I kind of wish there'd been a little bit of spanking, like, more, like, erotic
more
spanking, like, which there was not. Like, that's really my only complaint, but, you know, but, and they also make the comment on, because she says how she's so tall, and she never really gets to be the dainty girl with the guy, well, with Krampus, like, you know,
he can
rough her up a bit, like, she even says this in the thing, but there's no erotic spanking, so that is my only complaint.
Right. And, you know, and I noticed that, too. I was like, oh, I feel like there could have been a little bit more kinky of an edge with it.
Yeah. I mean, it was kinky, but, like, it was kinky only in the fact that, hey, it's, like,
a monster
guy. Like, you're not, I mean, you could argue that it's furry territory, but I don't...
No, I don't think that's the same thing, exactly.
You're probably, you know a little bit more about that than I do. I'm not trying to step on anybody's... Hooves.
I think that certainly there's a crossover with that, but, you know, I think it's, you know, it's kind of in its own category, really.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah. But no, it's really good, and, yeah, it's one of my, it's definitely one that I really appreciate that you brought into my life. I'm gonna definitely read it, like, probably twice more this season, because it's awesome, and Krampus, that Krampus is very sexy. He's like a German Krampus. So.
Yes, he has the accent in the story.
Yeah. Yeah, so, you know, Shape of Water did really well, you know, if they want to make Christopher Krampus into a movie or just a porn, you know.
I would totally watch it.
I would throw money at this.
Yes. Shut up and take my money.
Take my money! Do you have anything else you want to say about this?
It's like, guys,
awesome
you can get it on Amazon, like, tonight and be reading it. It's,
yeah,
you know,
can figure out what excites us.
It's an easy read.
Yeah.
You know, is it something, are you allowed to put the link in the comments?
I probably could, yeah, because it's on Amazon. It should be okay. Mm-hmm. I will. Otherwise, I'll just put, you know, how to spell everything right.
So you can find it.
Yeah.
But it's an easy read. It's, you know, it's, and you can, but it's a very, like, it's a good read. It's very
well
written.
Oh, yeah. It's, yeah, it's not, it's, I mean, it's trash, but it's, like, it's good trash.
Yes.
There's a level. I did read
elite
another Krampus book last year that was just awful. This one is the good one. So, A Kiss from Krampus, an erotic Christmas tale, as in, like, swishy tale, by Red Hanner. You should totally check it out. And I think this might almost wrap up the Krampus season for my videos. If you like this, please give it a thumbs up, you know, ring that jingle bell so you know when I post more videos. If you want to see more of me and Miss Amy Mercury, please let me know. Also, what do you have going on? Do you want to talk about how's your book going?
It's going well. Let's see, I'm nearing the end of chapter 2 on this. So,
Orc Girl.
I've got I've got like probably about less than 10 pages left chapter 2 will be finished, and I'm getting to the juice of the story.
Admittedly, I have been waiting for chapter 2 to be over to read it, because I knew that I was going to be like, oh, I'm just going to eat it all up.
I've had several people have said that. It's like, I'm waiting for you to get to the end of chapter 2 because I just want to read it all at once. And I'm like, well, I appreciate that.
Although chapter 1 was great and I loved it.
Thank you.
So where can they find you?
Actually, I have my own website now, orcgirl.com.
Ooh.
I update every Monday.
I will put that in the description. And, yeah, I have a happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and, you know.
Happy New Year.
Read the smutty book. If you have read it, let us know. Mm-hmm. If you read it after watching this video, let me know in the comments.
Yeah, because so we want to hear it.
I want to hear what you have to say.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.